attentively to questions and answers coming from the MD. But I hold the view that there are a lot of very clumsy presentation before us. Very clumsy in the true sense of budgeting and approval. I won't say this, let me call this say, Mr. President, Mr. Chairman, that most of the agencies that we have given autonomy to, that is the agencies where you see corruption well seated, corruption protected. Most of the agencies that they have autonomy. That is the truth. And I can mention so many agencies like that, that by the time you zero down and you take a critical look at the presentation, you just know that the more you are looking, the less you understand what they are presenting to you. I won't say that, Mr. Chairman and Chairman. You see, NIWA is located in my Senatorial District. And I do know that the last time I saw you was last year. But let me tell you, there were a lot of complaints about that agency. It's not what to discuss here, but I'm just giving you by way of notice. Maybe when we come on the oversight function, those things, I'll put them on the table. Because agencies are federal government organizations, and in all you do, it must reflect federal character, and you must be transparent, even in recruitment. Now, I cannot understand when you present a total overhead estimate, zero. I've never seen a budgeting system where you have zero. There's not any budgeting that statement of account that somebody will put zero. It asks, I mean, that calls for questions. Again, I think that's what they call consolidated accounts, where agencies are supposed to remit proceeds. If we continue giving autonomy to agencies, you discover that you wake up one morning, they will spend everything and they will give you zero. I mean, very simple. Look, if we want Nigeria to move forward, let us do things the way it should be done. Let there be proper accountability system, check and balances. It's not because of us, but because of our country. Mr. Chairman, to me, I don't know what you are going to arrive at, but I just see a very clumsy presentation before me. And the choice is yours to determine what you want to do. Assalamu alaikum.
The summary you have, we have gone through all the pages, and then I've seen all the projects listed. I remember this same time last year, I raised the issue of Akwa Ibom, Oron Jetty in Akwa Ibom State. And you did promise that something will be done. I've gone through, I've not seen anything reflected. That's an inland waterway jetty that was abandoned. It used to have ferry, no ferry, and we keep on losing lives every day. There are private people operating, but the environment there is very bad, that we need to do something about it. So I want it to be reflected, please. Thank you.
Let me start by saying that I'll be glad to receive all the complaints about the issues raised by Senator Adeyemi with regards to what is happening in NIWA. But I stand bold to be challenged that if we have, under my watch, if we have 100 staff in NIWA, that 56% of them, if not 60%, is from Kogi. Kogi. So,
both.
No, sir. There's a law directing us in terms of the junior staff. Sir.
Junior staff, yes, if you give power to the localities, yes, that's the policy. But for senior staff, it must be federal character. So if you give them 60%, then we're going to...
On the issue raised by distinguished senator with regards to Oron, yes, I remember I assured you that I'm going to work in Oron, and that we are doing. As we speak, we have signed an agreement with a company on a PPP arrangement to bring vessels to operate Oron Calabar axis. We are also addressing the issue of Oron Calabar jetty at the point outside the, or the, you know, the one we are using now most times is the Maritime Academy, Oron Jetty. But there's a new one. There's a new one. Yes, there's a, the particular old one is coming under our corporate social responsibility for that particular community because we've done the assessment. But as to putting ferries between Oron and Calabar, we've signed the agreement with a company. Yes, oh, okay, I don't know. They didn't tell me, but we have signed an agreement with them with regards to make that route very functional. It is economically viable. We've done the study, and that route is economically viable. So we have encouraged them, we've signed it, we have even offered them assistance and support to ensure that that route is opened.